Dr. Mindy here, and on this video, we are going to talk about a whole new hormone. So if you are new to my channel, welcome. Please subscribe. And as always, you guys, if you love this information, send it out into the world. The hormone I want to talk to you today is not insulin. We tend to think that insulin is the only hormone we need to manage in order to lose weight. On this video, I'm going to talk about a whole other hormone, your fat hormone, and what fasts you can use to be able to kick yourself out of resistance to this hormone. So stay tuned. Let's talk about insulin for a minute, and then I'm going to reveal the hormone. Okay? Let's start with this idea. Insulin is your fat storage hormone. Insulin is the hormone that will start pushing glucose and toxins and other hormones into your fat cells and will make you create more adipose tissue. But the hormone that I want to talk about today is actually one that affects how you burn that fat, and it's called leptin. It is your fat burning hormone. So, and they have found that, and I'll link the studies again, that they have found that people who carry more adipose tissue have more leptin. It is the number one driver of whether your body will access fat for energy and be able to burn fat. So when we come to fasting, what we're doing is we're really helping to regulate insulin. We don't want the body to store more fat. But we can't take out of our sight and out of our picture this hormone leptin. We need to tap into leptin to be able to get our body to burn fat again for energy. The thing I want you to know about leptin is just like all hormones, leptin isn't working on its own. It lives in the fat cells and it communicates with the hypothalamus in your brain. And when the hypothalamus knows that leptin is down there, it will create a signal that allows you to burn that fat for energy. But just like you get insulin resistant, you get leptin resistant. So there are three fasts that you can do that will help to start to kick you out of leptin resistance. So let's just dive into the research because the research is incredibly impressive on fasting and leptin. First study and first fast. Your 24-hour fast. Hopefully you guys know I love the 24-hour fast. It is one of my favorite, not only for gut reset, but off this study that I'm going to talk about right now, what they did is it was a study done on 14 obese women and 12 lean women. So it's a female study. Hallelujah. We don't have a lot of those in fasting, but you've got 26 women. About half of them were obese, half of them were lean. And they put them on a 24-hour fast. And here's what they found. They found some changes in leptin, but they also found changes in insulin. So I want to make sure that you're clear on the changes that happened in just one 24-hour fast. So they saw not only did their BMI start to go down, but their serum leptin went down. In the obese individuals, that leptin went down by 20%. In the lean individuals, leptin went down by 62%. So just in those two statistics, you could look at those and say, well, why did the lean people lose leptin so much faster from a 24-hour fast than the obese people? Because there are parameters that make you leptin resistant. So as we move through this week, we are doing fast training week this week. I am going to show you video by video what those parameters are. What is making people leptin resistant? But I first want you to understand that if you want to bring your leptin levels down so that your body can start to burn fat better, you're going to need to tap into some 24-hour fasts. Okay, the other thing in this study, by the way, is they saw insulin go down by 23% in both obese and lean women, which I think was quite interesting. Okay, second fast that is helpful to get your body burning leptin again and using this hormone efficiently. And it's any fast that will increase BDNF. So they have and studies are showing that the higher the BDNF, brain fertilizer, the lower the leptin levels. So, okay, let's go back to what we know about fasting. What is the number one fast that increases BDNF? I hope you guys know they've been following me for a while. it is the dry fast. So these are the Ramadan fast, people who are going sun up to sun down without any food or water for anywhere from 12 to 24 hours is what we recommend. No more than 24 hours for dry fasting. And of course, during Ramadan, they do it for 30 days. But you want to get your BDNF levels up so that your leptin levels can go down. Now, I'm going to, throughout this week, I promise you there are some really cool ways to get BDNF up other than just fasting. But fast number two is the dry fast. And then the third fast that I recommend to be able to become leptin sensitive again is anything that will stimulate autophagy. So the study that we are seeing, and this was a mouse study, that people who had a dysfunctional autophagy process in the cells, specifically in the hypothalamus of the brain, became more leptin resistant. So if you're hearing all of this and you're frustrated with losing weight, what I want you to know is there are three variations to fasting you're going to lean into. You're going to lean into the 24-hour fast. You're going to lean into some 12-hour dry fasting is where I would recommend you start. And then you'll lean into some autophagy fasting. Those are going to be your leptin sensitive fast. Those are going to be the ones that are going to go after your fat hormone. So now you compare when you eat, you can put that with certain foods. And as I go through this week, I'm going to show you what foods will help you become leptin sensitive, will get you burning this fat hormone again, and what foods you need to stay away from. So if you're, again, if you're new to my channel, please subscribe. We will all week long, I am bringing you leptin and fasting and what we can do to unstick your weight and free the fat is what I'm calling it. We're doing free the fat fast training week, which is geared towards getting you lasting results using the principles of fasting for your weight challenges. Okay, so there you go. Those are the three fasts. And what I want to tell you is that if you are confused, which I hope you're not, but if you are, everything I'm giving you guys over this week around this fat hormone, we have put together in a companion guide. So if you want the companion guide, just put companion guide in your comments and we will make sure that you get the companion guide and you can see it visually, everything that I'm discussing this week for yourself. But leptin, it is the hormone that we cannot forget. We've got to think not just about the fact that we need to manage insulin, but if we want to lose weight, we're going to have to manage leptin as well. As always, I hope that helps.